this for you. Give me your hand and we'll make it there soon. Life is just one beautiful view. We'll eventually get there. This is the pursuit. This is the pursuit. This is the pursuit.
Alright, what's up guys? Welcome to the stretching video. This will be a stretching video for microcycles 1 through 3. I'm going to keep it the same the whole time, just because it's easier to measure your progress that way. You can switch up the stretches if you want to, but for what I've laid out in the program, I'm going to keep it the same just to allow you to kind of feel and see how you're progressing and your flexibility throughout this. My philosophy on stretching is a little different than a lot of people's. You'll see a lot of people really straining to get as far as they can to a stretch. But when you do this, your muscles, they're going to sense that you're stretching farther than they want to go, and they're going to contract to protect themselves from stretching too far. And this is kind of counterproductive. So what I do when I stretch, I go just until I start to feel the stretch, and then I rest there. And instead of doing 5 or 6 seconds or holding it for a breath, I'll hold it for 30 seconds to 45 seconds and really let the muscle relax and elongate in that tiny little stretch. But I won't push it far enough to where the muscle wants to contract backwards to kind of protect itself. So without further ado, with that in mind, I'm going to take you through the basic stretches I do for the entire body after every workout. This should last you if you do the 30 to 45 seconds, 1 to 2 cycles of this, anywhere from 15 to 20 minutes afterwards. If you do it quick, maybe 10. If you take a longer time, maybe 25 minutes, depending on how much you want to put into it personally. The first stretch is hamstrings to groin. All it is going to be, you can do single leg, double leg, which is stretching forward very lightly, feeling that stretch underneath here, underneath the back of your knee. And just taking big, deep breaths here. After your time's up there, you're going to bring your feet together in front of you, holding them together, and again, feeling that light stretch right here in your groin area. Taking big, deep breaths, allowing it to open up. And you can even lean forward a little bit until you feel that stretch a little more. Again, don't push it too hard. Just take it nice and easy. This should be relaxing. This should be something after your workout that helps calm you down. You don't want to be straining in these. After you've done that once or twice, you can move into a hamstring, or sorry, I'm messing these up, quadriceps, or the front of your thigh and glutes. For quadriceps, I like to take a nice leisurely pose here, grab the back of my foot, and you're just going to pull it back gently. And all that's going to do is feel the stretch right in the front of your quad there. You're going to breathe through that again for 30 seconds, 45 seconds. And we'll roll over doing the other side as well. When you're done with that, we'll move into the glutes. For the glutes, all you're going to do is with your knees like this, you're going to take one foot and kind of bring it across here, almost like you're relaxing, sitting back on the beach or something. And you're just going to put one hand on the outside, and you're going to shoot one hand through that hole right there and grasp on the other side, and just lean back and breathe through it. You can rock a little. And you're going to feel this on the underside of that leg into your butt, basically, into your glutes. And again, do that for both sides of the leg. All right, after that, we've hit the legs pretty hard, got them nice and stretched out. We're going to move into our torso now, moving up the body. Going to do abs and back. Very simple exercise here. You'll see these in yoga a lot. You can do these with your feet off the ground, or sorry, your knees off the ground, or your knees on. All you're doing is pushing your belly button to the floor, looking up at the sky, feeling that stretch right through here in your abdomen. Then when you're done there, in that same position, we're just going to slide back and feel that stretch now right under your arm here in your back. And here, breathing through it again, nice deep breaths, and go back and forth there maybe 2 or 3 times. And after we've hit the torso, we're going to move into the upper body. So, for the upper body, you're going to be up now off your mat. We're going to do a kind of chest, shoulders, and biceps, triceps, all of those above. You can do them basically using just a wall. And I'll do it just for my right side, but you can do this for both sides of your body. So for the chest, the first one I like to do is placing my entire forearm up against the wall, twisting slightly until I feel that pull right across my pectoralis there. Breathing through it, nice gentle stretch. After that, we're going to go straight arm now. That's going to work more of the shoulder. Again, breathing through it, nice gentle stretch. You can also, instead of that one, you can pull across like this, will work the same way. You can even feel it right there as you're stretching, pulling right there. For triceps, all we're gonna do is basically put your arm up into the air, let it drop behind, grabbing the elbow, gonna pull gently on it until you feel the stress shooting down the back of your arm here. And like everything else, we're breathing through it, relaxing, letting the muscles stretch. If you wanna work your biceps and your forearms as well, using the wall, take your palm, we're gonna open it up. Now this is gonna stretch your entire forearm and bicep. And if you wanna increase the stretch, or if you're not feeling it by just putting your palm up, you can sink lower into it or shimmy your hand up the wall a little higher until you feel that stretch right there in the arm. After you've done the whole upper body, the one last thing I like to hit, just because it helps with your ankles and mobility, is calves. Now you can do these after you've done the leg ones, but I wait until I'm standing up to go into these. And calves, again, using the wall, all you're gonna do is put your foot comfortably up against the wall with your toes off the ground, maybe 4 to 5 inches, and your heel firmly planted into the ground. You're gonna move this foot backwards. You're gonna lean forward until you feel that stretch shooting up the back of your calf right there. Breathe through it. And like everything that has two sides, work the other side as well. And that'll be it for stretching. Again, I cannot stress enough, don't overdo it here. You're working really hard in the gym to build up your physique. You don't wanna ruin it by trying to stretch too hard and tearing something while you're supposed to be relaxing and kind of flushing all the lactic acid, all the blood out of the muscle, helping it cool off after a long, hard workout. But that's it, guys. I hope you've enjoyed. I hope this helped you. Feel free to subscribe to the channel as well. There'll be plenty of more helpful tips for you and your fitness journey there. And that's all. Have a nice day. I hope you enjoyed your workout.